we're building on 12 years of experience. We're building on 5 generations of aircraft, and we are carrying lessons learned from one aircraft to the next. And this is really important. Let's look at the specs. 4-seater, we're planning on flying between 25 and 4,000 feet AGL, less than 50 feet wingspan, 90 miles with range, with reserves, 90 mile range with reserves, 120 knot top speed, 50 minutes charge time, depending on the use case, could be less than that. You can bring your carry-on and personal items on board, and then autonomous with human oversight. We've also improved the configuration. Like, we have 6 tilting propulsion units on the front row. They generate lift during takeoff and landing, and then thrust during transition and cruise. On the back row, we have separate fixed propulsion engines. They generate lift during takeoff and landing, and then they lock into position during cruise. The intent is to reduce drag and optimize performance. It has a ton of benefits. It's highly redundant, it's highly modular, it's very agile, it's lower noise, lower weight, and it has a huge potential for performance improvement. We also raised the wing. So when you raise the wing, you increase the aircraft stability, which is better passenger comfort so that you don't get seasick. And we also extended the boom so that we move the fans away from the passengers. So it's more safety on the ground, but also in the air. We've also improved the design of the propellers themselves. So Jim mentioned that, the disc loading. So we tried to reduce the disc loading because that reduces noise and vibration levels. So we've increased the size of the propellers. We've added, larger number of propeller blades. So 5 on the front row, 4 on the back row. All of that is to reduce vibration levels, noise, improve the performance of the aircraft. And the most obvious change is the size of the cabin. It's a huge cabin. Like, you can sit 4 people, you have a ton of space. It's accessible to people with disabilities, as we talked about. It also opens up a ton of future use cases. Cargo, when you need more space, more volume. So it has a huge growth potential. And last, the tail. Very simple, cross tail, lightweight, reduce the number of parts. So that allows us to reduce the weight of the aircraft and optimize the CG location. So we try to keep it simple as much as we could. So let's talk about certification real quick. You probably already know, but we are pretty well engaged with the FAA. We are getting a ton of great support from the FAA. They've dedicated and allocated people to support the certification of that aircraft. That aircraft is going to be the first ever candidate for certification of a self-flying, all-electric, vertical takeoff and landing aircraft. We are just the first ones. This is just amazing. And guess what? We submitted a G1 earlier this year. We got amazing feedback from the FAA. We are actively going through the G2 as well with the FAA. And so it's really exciting to see how fast we're moving with the FAA and the level of engagement. They want this to work. They want this to happen. They are all in on this. So it's amazing. And we should just grasp that opportunity and push it forward.